Buddy, so last night I kind of started this thing where I wanted to try to do more of a series, and again, it's more for myself than anyone else because I don't have a following. Well, okay, I don't want to say I don't have a following, but this is my boyfriend Anderson,
Hey.
and I just wanted to like ask him a couple of questions on this channel. It's really special because I normally never would have anyone else on my channel, and definitely not a guy or a boyfriend. But this is my first relationship that's not toxic. Like that's more open
Open is good, right?
and there's a lot of special things about it. So I wanted to ask Anderson, because this is kind of like about mental health and stuff. So Anderson, if you're like gonna wake up one day and you're really nervous about something, there's some event or some job interview or whatever, how do you do to prepare yourself mentally to make sure that like you have the right tools emotionally or whatever, like so that you don't get anxious.
That's a good question. I usually meditate. I usually read a book or do something quietly, you know. It's really good to like get within yourself and try to prepare yourself for the day and not stress out too much. Again, I say that, but I also have a lot of struggles trying to focus on myself to get ready for the day. But yeah, that's how I usually start my day.
Okay, so like meditation, is that like the kind of stuff like you do at yoga or
It's
whatever?
not like, just like,
Is it
yoga. It's like,
the same as prayer, or do you add prayer to
no,
it,
it's
or?
simply just lying in bed and just thinking about how you're gonna process your day and how you're gonna do everything and, seeing how you can make it a better day,
Are you really good at staying in the moment? Like, can you? Because for me, I have a lot of trouble focusing and concentrating, and it's very difficult. I haven't been diagnosed with ADHD, but like sometimes I feel like it's almost impossible to meditate because you have to
Stay in the moment.
like for some reason like how do you clear your mind of thoughts? You know what I mean? So like, are you good at staying in the moment and being present?
It's not easy. It's not easy, and I gotta tell you, I don't always stay in a moment. I also do get distracted. That's why, like.
It's not always meditating for like 3 minutes because I can barely stay within it for like a minute.
Because
But
you do
at least
have,
I try, you
you're
know?
okay with saying that on the channel, right? Like,
Yeah.
he does have actual ADHD.
Yeah, I do, It's just like, there's nothing to be ashamed about it, It's just like, you gotta accept it, accept it for as is, And all it is basically you're unique. There's a uniqueness to it. And it just makes us unique. Everyone is unique in their own way. Everyone has something about them that makes them different. So you just gotta accept yourself and be cool about it. So, yeah, what about you,
Yeah, no, so that's definitely an insightful sort of thing with you. I feel like you and I are similar, but I think the difference between us is Anderson, you're very positive. Like, he's very
Thank
positive.
you, thank you.
Like, he's overall, he tries to
That's awesome.
not like wake up in the morning and be like, oh my gosh, this is gonna be a terrible day. Like, he just thinks, right?
Yeah, that's definitely true,
Like, what's your first thought in the morning? Like, usually, if there's.
First thought in the morning is like, I'm just like, you know what? I'm gonna have a positive day. Even if the end result may not always be positive, I'm gonna try to be positive. You gotta have that mindset sometimes. It's gonna be hard, right? But you gotta do it, Right?
Yeah, and it's just crazy because
You're so beautiful, by
you're a
the
lot you're a lot different from me, like with your background. I feel like you've had a lot of things that you've overcome and struggled with.
So have
For
you.
me, I think we're almost reverse of each other, but not quite. Like, it's kind of like I feel like I'm constantly thinking I had like kind of the perfect childhood, like kind of not perfect, but all my happy memories come from the past, and I've struggled more recently. Whereas I feel like with you had some hardships in the past that you are just trying to constantly overcome. And it's not like life's easy now, but like it's like a constant battle. Is that true?
Yeah, I mean, it can be a battle. It can be a battle between, things to happen. But again, like I'm trying to understand, like, is it a battle or is it something that I need to just move forward from, Because yes, we're all gonna have those moments where we're like, you know what, it's so hard. But again, as we mature through stages of life, we have to like find a way to cope with it. To like, how can we handle it and like put the stress behind us? They say like leave the baggage behind the door, kind of thing. Yeah, it's hard, but you have to kind of move forward and present yourself with this idea. You got this. You're going to do well, you know? Because I see it in you. I see it in me. You know, we have so much potential. And I see it in other people, too. For those of you out there, you know, if you're having a hard time, you guys got this, you know? Figure out something, you know? There's always some way to do something. Yeah. What do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, so let's talk about a little about, like, your opinion on, like, relationships outside of ours. So, like, we've been together for over 6 months, so a little over half a year. But the interesting thing and unique thing about our relationship, which sounds crazy to a lot of people, is not only have we been seeing each other, aside from, like, a week break, but really, but, like, we never were friends. We met and kind of fell in love. So there's been phases, like, we met and had an attraction and we, like, went out and then we took a break. But the thing is, like, of course there were waves, like, of, oh, I had to realize I really was committed and, like, in love with you. And then you
probably had moments where you're like, wait, I'm not sure. And now I feel, because all relationships have different waves and stages.
Yeah.
I have a history and a problem with, like, you're the first good result of it, but what's your opinion on, like, people being friends for years and then dating, or just being friends? The thing is, like, I really liked our relationship because he was the first guy who didn't try to friend zone me. That's why I kind of went in head on, even though I didn't know what I wanted, because I was like, I respected him, because usually guys, they kind of mess with your mind, and they, I don't know, at least that's my experience. So what do you think about that?
I see where you're going. Yeah, I think that, you know, it all depends on the person, right? You sometimes, I know.
Sorry, my hair's a constant battle.
She's like, wah!
My hair's a constant battle because it's, like, really sticky right now.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
I know.
Yeah, it's okay. You gotta admire her beauty at times, but, you know. I think, you know, the thing about, like, friends, getting to know each other as friends, you know, that's great, right? But then, you know, you have to understand that, like, being friends, it depends on who you are, you know. If you're trying to get to know the person, that's great. Sometimes it all depends on where you are in life, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes you hit it off really well, sometimes you don't. But, you know, it's for me, when I met you, it was like we just hit it off, you know. It was just, yeah, I just grabbed your hand and that was
it. It's like you can't,
you know?
See, people like to judge and be like, oh, girl, you were in a relationship, like, it's a rebound, or they put labels on it immediately, like, this is a rebound, this is too fast, this is this. But the thing is, like, I like what he's pointing out, that, like, it really depends on the people. And, like, even though in today's society you don't want to admit that we could have anything, like, when we started you might have thought it's going to just be something casual. And that's why I got so in my head and I did this stupid thing where I was like, let's take a week. It was only like a week, but it was like, I don't know if I want to label this anymore. And I kind of was listening to other girls and thinking, if they're not labeling their relationships, why do I have to label mine? But I was only second guessing our relationship because of what society was telling me. Basically, like, you can't actually be in love with someone you just met. Like, you have to be friends. And so I wanted to hold back and be friends. But then a lot of problems happened because when we weren't supposed to be friends, we're supposed to date. Like, we're in love. So, like, when I second guess that, then, like, other people get in the way and they get in the picture and it becomes messy, and I have a lot of trouble loving and respecting myself, and that's what I'm working on with mental health.
It's all right. Yeah,
so, yeah.
Take it easy. You gotta
do
well.
So, see, like, he's perfect for me because he's just really chill.
Yeah.
But we are cooking my favorite, very easy hamburger helper. And so we kind of cut off in the last part, but actually I want him to film because I want to show.
All right.
So. Ooh, okay. Sure. You can even if you want it. Okay. Anyway.
Go ahead.
So.
Say whatever you want.
So we're doing 1 pound, and this is 3 pounds.
Mhm.
And these are not mad. I'm not a cook. Okay. I make food so that I can eat it.
Okay.
So.
This is so meaty, baby.
I have washed my hands.
So meaty, so meaty.
I know.
Do you feel the juiciness?
It's juicy.
Yeah, I know, right?
So juicy.
Okay, get out of there.
Wash my hands. I'm gonna get cream.
Oh yeah.
Nice. I'm just gonna imagine that this is in thirds.
Okay.
So like, you know, one. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So that, because it's 3 pounds, right?
Yes.
And then just kind of take the 1 pound, one of the three, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna obviously store the rest of it again away.
Yeah.
And since I've washed my hands, I can just touch this and then I just have to wash them again.
Okay.
And then basically put it on here. Woo! It's gonna start cooking like crazy, so.
Okay.
The best thing to do is move it around. And I don't actually add oil because it's already got so much juice in it. And the first thing you need to do is just brown it. So browning the beef is wonderful. It's like amazing. It's like therapeutic because
basically see that it's red and then the parts that are red, you turn them onto the heat and get it brown. And it's like, it's therapeutic because it's like you're seeing yourself
definitely
accomplish
is.
Small
definitely
things.
Is. Yeah. You gotta make sure it's nice and brown, okay?
Yeah.
It's not brown, it's not cooked.
So I'm gonna let Anderson brown the beef.
Are you guys ready? Here we go.
Because I'm gonna have to put this away, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set the camera down. I don't know how well it's gonna work, so we'll just look at it later. But I'm gonna set it down because I need to put the beef out. So it's probably all cut off.
Good job. I don't even know how much of that was captured just now.
I'm capturing.
But he's got a different angle, so that's good. Yeah, I think it was too zoomed in, but whatever. You heard everything. So, yeah, I can't film too much more, but yeah, basically he's browning it. I just wanted to show you. Yeah, I know we cut off at the last interview we were doing, but I think that that's fine because a family who cooks together stays together.
That's right.
I don't know if that's actually even a phrase. But he's really great.
You want some salt on that?
So, no thank you.
Are you sure?